the importance of this drug. So in Charaka Sutras, the first chapter, that is Dirganjivitiya Dhyaya. The second chapter, he used to explain Apamarga Dhanduliya Dhyaya, where all the preparations or whatever the things he used to explain, that is for Antaha Parimarjana Chikitsa, for Antaha Parimarjana, that is for Shodhanartha, he used to explain, he used to like Shirovirachana Dravyas, Vamaka Dravyas, Virechaka Dravyas, whatever the things he used to explain in Charaka Sutrasthana, second chapter, that is for Antaha Parimarjana Chikitsa. So to expel the vitiated doshas from, by taking the internal administration of the Dravyas. Okay, so among them, the first drug he used to explain under Shirovirechaka Gana is Apamarga. So that's why he has given the name as Apamarga Thanduli Adhyaya. Okay, so it shows the importance of this drug, Apamarga. Even since from Vedic period, we are getting a lot of explanation, especially regarding this Apamarga. We are getting information that is in Rigveda has not mentioned, but in Yajurveda, Samaveda, Atharvaveda, we'll get a detailed description. Even the preparation of Kshara is also mentioned in Samhita Kala itself. Its utility, especially in Yajurveda, the Sattu, they have used the term Sattu, that is the extract, the powder form of the Apamarga Bija, that is used as a Rakshogna Karma, that they are using as it is a Rakshogna Karma. Okay, so if you want, you can note the introductory point. So in Rigveda, we do not find the reference regarding Apamarga, but in Yajurveda, we'll get a clear picture, the informations in Yajurvedic period, that is the churna, the powder of Apamarga is used for Rakshogna Karma. Okay. And it is also used to remove the excessive water from the sharira. So see, in Vedic period itself, they are using this drug. That is for Shoshanartha, to do the Shoshana. See, only to remove the excessive water, not the normal water. The fluid which is accumulated in the peritoneal cavity or in the extracellular the fluid, that is excessive water. Wherever the excessive water is accumulated, so that water will be evaporated, that will be removed because of its Shoshana properties. Okay. And the other properties, like they used to say, is Papanashana, Mrityunashana, Duswapna Nashaka. See, all these are the synonyms and even the karmas of Apamarga. So till today, some of the peoples in the villages, they used to keep the Apamarga, the inflorescence below the pillows to avoid this Duswapna Nashaka karmas. They are believing that. Okay. So Duswapna Nashaka, Papanashaka, and Mrityunashana. So these are the karmas they have mentioned in Vedic period. Okay. Apart from that, so the process of preparation of Apamarga Kshara is also delineated in Vedic period itself. Okay. Since from Vedic period, we are getting information regarding Apamarga, its utility, its synonyms, its actions, and its preparations, so in detail. So there is no such drugs like this. You will not get any type of drugs. So this is the one drug we'll get maximum explanation in Vedic period. Okay. So even Atharva Veda extensively quoted Apamarga, and according to the etymology, he provided that Shayana. Shayana, he is the author of the Brahmana Granthas in the Vedic period. So he used to define the Apamarga as Apakrutya Doshan Shariram Marjayati. Apakrutya Doshan Shariram Marjayati Shodayati. One which removes Apakrutya Doshan, the vitiated doshas. So Apamarga is the one which removes the vitiated doshas from the Sharira, and also it does the Shodhan of the Sharira. So this is the definition is given by Acharya Shayana in Vedic period itself. Okay. And the properties attributed to this plant, that is in Atharva Veda, they are saying that it's Sahasravirya. Even as you all know, the Hingu, Sahasraviryam Jetukam. Okay. So Hingu is also having the Sahasravirya. That is based on the actions. It is having the synonym. That is, it is indicated or it is used in thousands of diseases because of its potency. Because of its properties, in so many conditions they are using this drug. Okay, that is Sahasravirya. Krimignam, even Acharya Charaka has also mentioned in Krimigna Mahakashaya. See, in Vedic period itself they have mentioned because of its properties. So it is having the properties like Tikta Katurasa, Ruksha Guna, Ruksha Tikshna Gunas, Ushnavirya. That is in Krimi, in the concept of Krimi, while explaining Acharya Charaka, in Charaka Vimarasthana, 7th chapter, he used to say, that is the Chikitsa Sutras, Apakarshana, Prakruti Vighatana, and Nidhana Parivarjana. There are three principles, main three principles to treat the Krimis. So, one among them is Prakruti Vighatana Karma. So, Prakruti Vighatana, that is, which is not favorable conditions. The drugs one which will not provide the favorable conditions for the Krimis. So those, the drugs, they used to destroy the Krimis. So those drugs, they used to mention under Krimigna Mahakashaya. Okay, that we'll discuss later. Okay, so it is having the Krimigna properties. It also is having Rakshogna. So while doing any Homa and places, they used to use this drug as a Rakshogna properties. It also is having Rasayana, Arshogna properties, Kshuda, Trushna, Marhana. So there is one condition called Basmaka Roga. So where the person, if he consumes sufficient quantity of food, if he takes, so another 10 minutes or another half an hour, once again he used to take whatever the earlier half an hour before what he has taken, the same quantity of food he used to take. That is, whatever the food he used to take, that they used to get Basma. So it will not nourish the Sharira. That is, is a Basmaka Roga. So I think you have studied in Roga Nidana. So in such type of conditions also they used to say Kshuda, that is in case of Basmaka Roga, Kshuda and Trishna Marana. And also it is having Vishagna properties. One of the synonym is given by the Nikantokaras is Mayuraka. So Mayuraka, that is they used to compare with the peacock. And also they used to say how the peacock they used to do they used to take this one, the poisons, in the same way it nullifies the effect of Visha. They used to say Vishagna. And Ashmari Nashana Karmas, as it is one a potent alkaloid, okay, which is going to act. Okay, even Charaka considered Apamarga as the best drug among the Shirovirachana Dravyas. In Charaka Sutrasthana 25th chapter, while explaining about the Agra Dravyas, he used to say Shirovirachananam, that is Apamarga Shirovirachananam Sreshtam. He used to say, okay, among the Shirovirachana Dravyas, Apamarga is best one. So next we'll move to the basonym of Apamarga. See the name Apamarga. Apa means somewhat like obstruction, or one which obstructs the srotasas or the channels. So here, apakritya doshan shariram marjayati shodayati. The name, because of its property, because of its tikshna guna. So if you take the powder, the odor of the drug, like I think we are very familiar with like maricha, the odor of the drug, immediately when it comes in contact with the nose, immediately they used to spread. And they used to does the sroto shodhana karma. That is, please, you can recollect Pramati properties. Nijavirena yadravyam srotobhyo dosha sanchayam nirashyati pramati syat tadyata maricham vacha yavaha. So how the maricha, vacha and yava, because of its tikshna guna, nijavirena, because of its potency, srotobhyo dosha sanchayam. So whatever the doshas, the vitiated doshas which are accumulated in the srotas, so those doshas will be expelled by, because of Nijavirena, because of its properties, because of its potency, they used to clear the srotasas. In the same way, this Apamarga is also, when you are using for Nashya Karma, so they used to, because of its Sukshma Sroto Ghamitva Guna, Sukshma Sroto Ghamitva Guna, Tikshna properties, so whatever the doshas which are accumulated in the srotas, so they used to remove because of this Sukshma Sroto Gami Guna. And they used to expel it out in the form of Kshabatu. Okay? That is Apakritya Doshan Shariram Marjayati Shodayati. The plants, one which removes all the vitiated doshas from the body, and also it purifies the body. That is the basonym of Apamarga. Okay, the botanical source, the botanical name, Acaranthus aspera. Acaranthus aspera is the botanical source for Apamarga. So Acaranthus word is derived from the Latin word Acanthus. Acanthus means that is like a thorn. In the name itself, it they have given the specific feature. You have already seen the inflorescence. The inflorescence is having very difficult to hold. That is, they have given the synonym as Durgraha, Dusparshas, because this inflorescence is having the spine-like structures. Okay, the bracteoles are having sharp. Because of that nature, they have given the name as Acaranthus. Acaranthus word is derived from the acanthus, which means thorn, means sharp point-like structures will be present. Okay, aspera, that is the inflorescence which is having a sharp point-like structures. For that, they have given the species as aspera. Okay, Acaranthus aspera, and it belongs to the family Amaranthaceae family. That is Apamarga kula, Amaranthaceae family. There is only two drugs in your syllabus. The drugs which are belongs to the Amaranthaceae family. One drug is Apamarga, that is the detail drug, and another drug that is non-detail drug. We used to call it here in Karnataka. We used to call it as Gorakshanja. Goraksha Ganja. That is Irva Lanata. It is one of the botanical Goraksha Ganja is the name given by Acharya Priyavrat Sharma. That is specifically indicated in case of Ashmari. So in Karnataka, we are using in the name of Goraksha Ganja. That is Irva Lanata. Kannadalli hittulu kaanta karitevi. Okay. So it is abundantly available, or it is a weed, especially in South India, or especially in Karnataka. Okay, so Goraksha Ganja and Apamarga, these are the two drugs which are belongs to Amaranthaceae family. So both the drugs are, the swarupa is Kshupa. It is an erect herb. Okay, so you can easily remember the vernacular names of Apamarga. In Hindi it is called Chirchiri. In English, it is called prickly chaff flower. Prickly chaff flower. So this is one of the neat examination or one of the viva voce questions also. Which drug or which plant is called as prickly chaff flower? So in neat examinations, they used to ask such type of questions. Okay, English name you can remember, prickly chaff flower. Kannadalli Uttrani, Uttrani Kaddi. Next, we'll move to the Ganas. According to Charaka, it is mentioned under Krimigna Mahakashaya, Vamanopaga Mahakashaya, Shiro Virechanopaga Mahakashaya. Even Acharya Charaka, it is mentioned in Sutrasthana second chapter, that is Shiro Virechaka Ganas. So this is the one drug which is mentioned in Shiro Virechaka as well as Shiro Virechanopaga. Actually, Shiro Virechaka is entirely difference. There is a lot of difference is there. Shiro Virechaka and Shiro Virechanopaga. But here, this drug which is mentioned as a Shiro Virechaka and also as well as Shiro Virechanopaga. Okay. And according to Shushruta, it is under mentioned under Arkhadigana. Okay, we'll see one by one. So Krimigna Mahakashaya. So as you all know, the Krimigna Dravyas. That is in Charaka Sutrasthana, fourth chapter, in Shadvirekana Shatashriti Adhyaya. So mentioned in the second 10, that is Truptignam, Arshognam, Kushtagnam, Kandugnam, Krimignam. That is 15th Mahakashaya, Krimigna. So there he used to say, Krimin Hanti Iti Krimignam. Krimin Hanti Iti Krimignam. The drugs one which kills, the drugs one which removes, or the drugs one which expels the krimis. That is called as Krimigna Dravyas. So there are three types of krimis. That is Antahakrimi, Bhayakrimi, and treatment principles. They used to explain Antah Krimigna Dravyas, Bahir Krimigna Dravyas, and Krimini Saraka Dravyas. There are mainly three types of the Krimigna Dravyas are there. Okay, Antahakrimigna Dravyas means the drugs one which kills inside the body. That is Antahakrimigna Dravyas, and Bahyakrimigna Dravyas. The Bahya Krimis, Yuka Pipilika. There are two types of Bahya Krimis. That is Bahya Krimis, Yuka Pipilika. With the help of like by using the yantras or by with the help of the hands, you can remove. That is apakarshana, nidhana parivarjana, prakriti vigatana, apakarshana. So with apakarshana means you can remove it, you can expel it out by using your with the help of any yantras or with the help of the hands. That is bahinissaraka. You can expel with your hands or instruments. And the third one is kriminissaraka, one which expels the krimis which are present in the inside the body. So those krimis will be killed, and they used to expel it out. For that they used to say kriminissaraka dravyas. Okay, so antahakrimigna, so you can compare in modern as anthelmintics. Antahakrimigna dravyas you can compare with anthelmintic drugs or vermicide, and bahyakrimigna dravyas you can compare, or you can say as they used to say insecticides. Bahyakrimigna dravyas you can say like insecticides, and the third one is kriminisaraka, that you can say vermius. Okay, so these are the three terms, technical terms, please remember while explaining about the krimi chikitsas. Okay, so what are the krimigna dravyas acharya charaka has mentioned in sutrasthana fourth chapter? So the first drug he used to mention like akshiva maricha gandhira kyabuka. The four drugs, akshiva maricha gandhira kyabuka vidanga nirghundi svadhamstra akuparnika urushaparnika. Okay, so these are the 10 drugs, please remember: akshiva, maricha, gandhira, kyabuka, vidanga, nirghundi kinihi svadhamstra akuparnika urushaparnika. So here kinihi is a synonym of apamarga. Okay, so first one is akshiva. As you all know, the akshiva is the synonym of shigru, means the patra swaras of shigru, that is moringa oleifera, is used to treat, to kill the worms which are present in the eyes, chakshu. Akshiva, the drugs one which kills the worms which are present in the eyes, that is called as akshiva. Especially in case of like abhishandhya, like the conjunctivitis, in kafaja abhishandhya, where you can compare with the madras eye, where the person is sometimes like unable to open the eyes because of that pichala property, stickiness, the netra mala, and where there will be a continuous the srava is there, and sometimes even burning sensation is there, and the redness of the eyes is also there. So in such type of conditions like kafaja abhishandhya, so there you can use the shigru patra swarasa. The shigru is having a tikshna guna. The shigru patra swarasa is having a tikshna guna. So even a single drop of shigru patra swarasa which will kill the worms which are present in the eyes. Okay, that is akshiva. And maricha, as you all know, this is prakriti vighatana karma. Maricha is having sukshma srotogami guna, and it is also having prakriti vighatana karma. That is usually when you take the madurasatmaka dravyas or gurushnigdha pichala gunas, snigdha gunatmaka dravyas, the krimi vardhana is going to take place. So opposite to these properties, if you take like katutikta kashayasatmaka dravyas, ushna tikshna gunatmaka dravyas, so which will destroys the favorable, the environment which causes the krimis, so they used to destroy. So that's why the maricha is best prakriti vighatana karma dravyas. Okay, akshiva maricha gandhira, so gandhira, it is a synonym of hingu, that is the stem of here they are using the stem, not the niryasa, stem of the ferula narthex, that is hingu, they are using in case of krimi. Even the hingu is also having ushna tikshna properties. Okay, so because of this tikshna guna which will does the prakriti vighatana karma. Okay, akshiva maricha gandhira kyabuka is costisiosa, which is belongs to gingiberaceae family. We used to call it as an insulin plant. Okay, so that is also which is useful in case of to treat the krimis. And vidanga, Even Acharya Charaka says the Shrestha Krimigna Dravya is Vidanga. Vidanga Krimignanam Shrestham. Okay, best Krimigna Dravyas. Next, Nirgundi. So Nirgundi, even though it is best Vata Shamaka, which is useful in case of Vata Javikara, apart from that, which is also indicated in case of the Krimigna Karmas. Okay, so Vidanga, this Nirgundi, Kinihi, that is Apavarga, because of its Tikshna properties. Because of it is having the Tikta Katrasa, Ruksha Guna, Thara Guna. So because of all these properties, which will destroys the Krimis. Okay. And Kinihi, Swadhamstra. Swadhamstra, that is synonym of Gokshura. So even Gokshura first, which will enhance. Gokshura is having Madhura Madhura Shita. Madhura Rasa Madhura Vipaka Shita Virya. First, it does the vardhan of the krimi and they used to expel it out. Okay, like when Vamana Karma used to do, first we'll do the utklesion of the kapha and then we used to expel it out. In the same way, the Gokshura is also they are using. Okay, then lastly, the two drugs, Akuparanika and Rushaparanika, that is Ipomia reniformis, Ipomia, the species which are also useful in case of to treat the krimis. So, this is about the Krimigna Mahakashayas. Then Vamanopaka Mahakashaya. So you have discussed in Vamanopaka Mahakashaya. That is the drugs one which enhances the potency of Vamaka Karmas. The drugs one which enhances the potency of the Vamaka Karma. So those drugs are called as Vamanopaka Dravyas. So under Vamanopaka Dravyas, so you can remember that is he used to say like Madhu, Madhuka. So this is the one, this is also another one Mahakashaya here. Jangama Dravya and Audbhuta Dravyas are there. In Shonita Sthapana Mahakashaya, while discussing about Kunkuma and Keshara, we have discussed about Shonita Sthapana Mahakashaya. There Jangama Dravya, Audbhuta Dravya and Parthiva Dravyas are. In the same way, in Vamanopaka Mahakashaya also, you can see Jantavya Dravya as well as Audbhuta Dravya. So the Jantavya Dravya, the first one drug is Madhu. So Madhu, Madhuka, Kovidara, Karbudara, Neepa, Vidula, Bimbi, Shana Pushpi, Sada Pushpi, Pratak Pushpi, or Prateka Pushpi. Okay, so these are the 10 drugs which are useful in enhancing the potency of Vamana Karma. Okay, so this the first one is Madhu. As you all know, Madhu is one of the Jantavya Dravya. In so many preparations, that is, as Madhu is having Madhura Kashaya Satmaka Dravyas, one which enhances the Kapha Vardha first. By enhancing the kapha, and then they used to do the shaman of the kapha. Okay, first we will enhance it, then and they used to do the shaman of the kapha. So Madhu, Madhuka, that is ST Madhu, glycerin is a glabra. It is a more sweeter than the sharkara or guda because of the presence of the glycyrrhizin. Okay, that is the fanta we used to prepare, ST Madhu fanta, for to do Vamana Karmas. Okay. So Madhu, Madhuka, Kovidara and Karbudara. Kovidara and Karbudara, please you can remember, these are the synonyms of this one, Bahuviniya Virgeta, Kanchanara. Kovidara and Karbudara are the synonyms of Kanchanara. Okay, so Madhu, Madhuka, Kovidara, Karbudara. Nipa. Nipa is a synonym of Kadamba, Anthocephalus Kadamba. Vidhula. Vidula, it is a synonym of Hijjala, that is acute angula, Bandiniya acute angula, Hijjala, and another the drugs like Sadapushpi. Sadapushpi, it is a synonym of Arkha, Pratakpushpi. Pratakpushpi is a synonym of Apamarga. Okay, see there are three synonyms based on the flowers. Sadapushpi, Pratakpushpi, Shana Pushpi. Shana Pushpi is Crotaloria varicosa. It is very commonly available in our gardens. Okay, all the drugs are available in our garden. So you can go through the drugs which are useful in case of which enhances the property or the potency of Vamaka Dravyas. Okay, so this is about Vamanopaka Mahakashaya. Then Shirovirechanopaka Mahakashaya. That is the drugs one which will enhance the potency of Shirovirechana Dravyas. Like the Shirovirechana Dravyas, as you all know, which are having Ushna, Tikshna Guna, Katurasatmaka Dravyas are there. Like the first drug they used to explain in Sutrasthana second chapter. अपमार्ग So the drugs one which enhances the property of these drugs, those drugs are called as shiro virechanopaka mahakashayas. So we see in another context we'll discuss about shiro virechanopaka mahakashayas. Okay, so next we'll move to the synonyms of apamarga. So based on the inflorescence, it is having the synonym as karamanjari. So the synonym of apamarga based on the inflorescence, karamanjari. Manjari means the inflorescence. I think you come across with another one of the non-detailed drug is Harita Manjari. That is Acalepa Indica. Acalepa Indica, Harita Manjari. Manjari means inflorescence, the flowers which are having green in color. That's why they used to call it as Harita Manjari, Acalepa Indica. In the same way, Khara Manjari. Manjari, that is the inflorescence, the flowers which are rough to touch. Khara, the sparshanindriya pariksha. That roughness is because of the, see, kantakitvat karasparshah pushpamanjari. The pushpamanjari, the inflorescence, which are rough to touch because of the kantakitvat, because of the thorns, because of the spines. That is the bracteoles. If you see the flowers, you will come to know that. Just 1 minute, I will show the flowers. Yes, in this picture you can observe. Yes, in this picture you can observe. So these are called the bracteoles. So these bracteoles are having a sharp point like structures. So because of this, we are unable to touch. And if you touch, that is, it will be roughness is there. So because of these, the prickles, these spines, they used to call dusparsha, durabigraha or durgraha and karamanjari. So these are the synonyms because of, based on this inflorescence. Okay. Yes, karamanjari. Kantakitvat karasparshah pushpamanjari. The inflorescence which are rough to touch because of the kantakas, because of the spines. Okay, karamanjari. Adhashalya. Adhashalya. That is kantaki pushpan pushpanam adomukatvat. The flowers are deflexed. The flowers are, you can observe. So these are the flowers. So this is the main peduncle, the stalk or the main peduncle. So over that, the flowers are attached on a spike resume inflorescence, where the flowers are attached in downward directions. They are looking in adhomukha. They are being deflexed, or they used to say reflexed also. Okay. Adashalya, the flowers are situated, the flowers are attached to the main peduncle and they're looking in downward directions. Okay, so based on that, they have given the synonym as Adashalya. So, Kantaki Pushpanam Adomukatvat, the flowers are having the spines and they are deflexed in nature. Adomukatvat, because they are looking in downward directions. Okay, Adashalya. Durgraha, durgraha or durabigraha. So it is difficult to touch because of the kantakitvat gruhitam kashta, which produces pain, which produces the pain when you touch this plant, the flowers, because of the presence of the thorns. Durgraha. Okay, kantakitvat gruhitam kashta, when you hold the inflorescence. So, because the inflorescence or the flowers are having a sharp pointlike structure, so which will produce a pain. That's why they used to call it as durgraha. Okay, shikari, that is based on the inflorescence. Shikare pushpa manjaritvat, that is the terminal inflorescence. At the terminal part, the inflorescence they used to develop. So, based on that, they have given the synonym as shikari. Shikare pushpa manjaritvat, the flowers which are, that is the inflorescence is a terminal at the end of the branches. That's why they used to call it sikara, terminal part, shikari. Prateka pushpa, pratyamchi adamukani pushpanyashaha. The flowers are situated in downward directions, and individual pratyamchi, the individual flowers which are situated on the main peduncle of the Acaranthus aspera. Okay, pratak pushpa pratyamchi adamukani pushpanyashaha, the individual flowers which are directly attached to the main peduncle. So all the synonyms are based on the inflorescence itself. Okay, karamanjari adashalya shikari pratak pushpa, so based on the inflorescence. Even durgraha also, that's the inflorescence of the flowers which contains the spinous part. Okay, so next, based on the actions, margaha majiyati margan srotamsi iti, one which clears the srotas, one which clears the channels because of its tikshna guna, because of its properties. So one which clears the srotas is called as margaha. Okay, then kshara madhyaha, among the kshara it is a shrestha the drug. Okay, kshara madhyo ghatre asya aushade ksharaha pradhanyatvat pradhanatvat. So among the ksharas, I think you come across with the ksharadvaya, ksharatraya, kshara panchaka, ksharashtaka. So among them, apamarga kshara they used to consider, because whole plant contains the alkaline nature. So because of this, they used to consider as it is kshara shrestha. Okay, mayurakaha, mayura eva vishagnaha. How the mayura, they used to does the vishagna properties in the same way. This plant is also does vishagna karma. Atava minati hinasti rogan, one which cures the so many diseases, one which cures the diseases. So by that also they used to give the synonym as mayuraka. And there is one more, the meaning is there, mayuraka, when you see the crest of the peacock, how the color of the crest of the peacock will be present in the similar way, the inflorescence is having that type of color. The inflorescence of apamarga is having the color as like that of crest of peacock. They used to give the resemblance. Okay, based on the actions, based on the morphology, you can